I'm Richard Dolan, and you're listening to the Unedited Audio Experience with Sandra Schuffelbossom.
Hello, good evening, and welcome once again to my part of your day. And if you were listening last week, you would have heard me saying that I wanted to talk to Cobra, and that I did very successfully. And we didn't waste much time with pleasantries, and we begin with a question. Tell me about the Archons.
Okay, the Archons are the beings who are controlling quarantine Earth for the last 25,000 years. And they are present mostly on the non-physical planes. A small number of them are also present on the physical plane, and they are the ones who are actually responsible for maintaining the status quo on this planet for the last 25,000 years.
Who are the Chimera?
Chimera group is actually one group of the Archons that is actually at the top, and they are very much involved with technology. They are preventing extraterrestrial contact and any significant contact with the light with their technologies around the planet Earth.
Okay. So what about this Federal Reserve being disbanded?
Well, as you can see, it's still functioning, and all those rumors, before they are supported by real events, are just rumors.
Right, so it is just rumors at the minute?
Yes.
Okay. Tell me about the oil communicating with itself.
Actually, yes, the oil within the Earth's crust is actually a communication medium that allows communication on the non-physical planes, because there are many currents of energy flowing through the crust of the Earth, and oil is a communication medium for those ley lines within the Earth's crust.
This shift started since the equinox.
Yeah, the equinox actually happened in September.
So since then, what's been happening since the equinox then?
Well, the process of planetary purification is continuing.
Purification?
Yes.
That's what's happening?
Yes.
Cool. You're saying that the elites will try and vaccinate, you know, over this Ebola nonsense?
Yes, they are attempting to, but I don't think they will be very successful. They might have isolated success in the United States, but I think in the other countries it's not realistic.
What is this Moondust project?
Moondust project is actually a classified project which has been created by the Chimera group with the purpose of removing all evidence of extraterrestrial contact from surface populations. So whenever there is a certain UFO crash or anything of that nature, they deploy a certain special team which goes to the site whenever on the planet they remove the evidence immediately.
Like Men in Black?
Yes, very, very similar to Men in Black, yeah.
Okay. So when do you think we'll get to a moneyless world? I know there are these big jumps and gaps in between these questions. When do you think we'll get there?
We'll get there at a certain point after the event when the advanced technologies are introduced and humanity will be transformed enough in consciousness so that this is possible. It will take some time.
Tell me about this event. When can you give me any sort of time?
No, I'm not giving any time frames for that. There are so many factors involved in determining when this will happen, and even if I would know, I would not tell, because there are certain forces that better not know when this happens.
Yeah, okay, I can get you there. And I've written, is Quasi coming back? You're not Quasi Kotal. Quasi, he's supposed to. I've got this friend that knows a lot about crop circles, and he says that in the crop circles, he says that Quasi Kotal's coming back. I'm saying it wrong, but Quasi Kotal or whatever.
People have different interpretations of the crop circle, but actually the light forces are returning, and there were many prophecies about it, including the Mayan prophecies that were speaking about it, but it's universal process, not just limited to the Mayans or their culture. It's a universal process.
So the crop circles are real and being done by ET?
Some of them are real and some of them are fake. So there are certain groups who are actually making those crop circles for various reasons, but there are many real ones also.
what groups are making, what ET groups are making the crop circles?
Many of them are being made by the Pleiadians.
Pleiadians? How come you've not come before now? Do you know what I mean? Because things have got so bad and they're only going to get worse. And could you have not come before now?
What could not come before now?
Your lot. We've needed help for quite some time, you know, really, haven't we? We have on this planet. And I think, you know, we could have used a bit of help before now.
Situation was not ready. The plan was not ready. The conference was not ready. So things can only happen when people have enough awareness to receive them.
Okay. What's your take on Jesus?
Well, he was one of the light beings, like many other light beings, and his story has been greatly distorted. His message has been greatly distorted.
Answer, yeah.
Well, so tell me, what would you say? What was his message?
His message was the message of love. This was his basic message, and very few people got that message at the time.
Yeah, and it just got all screwed up, didn't it? You know, it's horrible the way it all got distorted with Jesus. Because I just think he was a cool guy that walks about, you know, I mean, kicks a few tables over. He was a cool guy. And, you know, the first hippie, he was a cool guy. Tell me about Karen Hudes.
And what would you like to know about her?
Well, she used to work for the World... Well, you know, she used to work for the World Bank. And she's saying that tall greys are running the show in America, you know. So how true is that?
Well, I think she has a certain degree of expertise in the banking circles, but she is saying many things about ET situation that might not be completely correct.
Yeah, so you don't think she's got the full picture?
No, not really.
Okay.
She has some interesting intel, but as with anybody else, you need to use your own discernment.
Okay. What about these Mars jump rooms? Do they exist?
Who?
The Mars jump rooms. You know, Andrew Bassett.
Yeah, there was a part of the secret space program, and those things were developed since 1950s and were quite much in use, but now the light forces have removed everything of that nature from the Chimera group and from the negative military. Does not exist anymore.
So Andrew Bassiego is telling the truth?
Yes, he is speaking quite much about this, and I would not say that everything he says is correct, but the general picture is right. Yes, there has been a secret space program, and yes, the United States had a strong presence on Mars in the last, I would say, 50 or 60 years.
Right. So you can't tell me nothing about the event. But what's going to happen after the event?
After the event, there will be a great transformation of humanity. First, people will realize what was going on. It will be quite much of a shock and of an awakening. And then people will begin to be open much more for the presence of our star brothers and star sisters. After the event, we will enter a process of preparing for the first contact. And after the first contact, of course, the story will be much, much more... much brighter and much more positive for humanity.
So the event isn't first contact?
The first contact happens after the event.
Yeah, so these separate things.
Yes.
So we don't quite know what the event is.
And the event is the moment when there will be the mass arrest of the cabal. It will be the moment of the financial reset and the moment of the release of secret files about the UFO presence, about the government involvement in the UFO question, and many suppressed technologies will begin to be released.
And you can't give me any sort of time frame?
No, I'm not giving any time frames.
Well, is there anything else you want to say to, you know, England, the people of Manchester and whoever else that will be listening to it?
Well, I would say that England is one of the key countries on the planet for the process of the planetary liberation. It has a great culture, a great background, and this background has been used many times it has been misused, but now it is a possibility and an opportunity for this country to use its resources in a positive way. It's time now.
But he won't be with, obviously, the government that's in now.
Well, I'm not speaking about government. I'm speaking about the people.
Ah, right. And this is all going to happen after the event?
Yes, but now we are in the time when we have to prepare, and it is good for people to do as much as they can to assist in the liberation.
So, and what would that be?
Well, people can meditate, people can organize physical action, they can start making groups, they can spread information and do whatever they feel inspired to trigger the change.
Yeah. Like me talking to you now and
yes, yes, that's part of the change, exactly.
Brilliant. Who's getting rid of the Archons and the Chimerans?
The Light Forces, the Pleiadians, other Star Races and the Resistance Movement.
Who is in the Light Forces apart from the Pleiadians?
Syrians, Andromedans and other races. There are quite many races, but the Syrians and Andromedans are the most frequent among them.
And what interest do they have in Earth?
We would like to assist the planet in the liberation process so that we can join the Galactic Confederation, the family of life.
Yeah, and they don't want anything else? They don't want anything off us, you know?
They have no personal agenda, if you're asking.
Well, that's me, because everyone seems to have an agenda, you know what I mean? So it's like the Greys, they've got their agenda, haven't they? And so there's no agenda with these Palladians and Syrians and...
No,
zero. None at all. They're just here to help.
Yes, exactly.
Is it them that left us in the first place?
I don't understand.
Well, didn't they sort of like have an hand in making us, making humans, and then something happened, and then they all got off and left us to it? Is that not the case?
No.
So what about things David Icke says? What do you say about that?
David Icke he made a great job in awakening the masses about the reality of the Illuminati, about the reality of the reptilian. So he is now even speaking about the Archons, which is very good.
Yeah, so you like David Icke and what he's saying?
He's making a very good job. I would say that he has awakened quite many people.
Yeah, he has that. He's done that all right. And what about Russell Brand?
Well, there are many other people who are also doing in their own way. I would not comment on everybody, but I would say that there are many people who are following their guidance and doing their mission their own way.
So you still can't give me any time frame on when it's going to happen, but it is going to happen.
It's going to happen, yes. This is 100% sure, but I'm not giving any time frames.
100% sure that everything's going to change. All the governments are going to change.
Yes, everything is going to change.
And we're going to end up living in a beautiful world, like we should?
Yes, exactly.
And are we going to get free energy?
Also, yes.
Brilliant. I want it to start, like, now. I can't wait. Oh, well, thank you, Cobra. Made up. I'm so happy that I've had a gab with you. So thank you very much, Cobra, for doing this interview with me. I'm completely made up with it, because I don't think anybody else in England has interviewed you. So have they?
Not yet.
So I am the first. Yay, get in. So I'm made up with that. First time I've used Skype, first time I've recorded it, and the first time I've spoke to Cobra. And will you come on again?
It's possible, yes. We'll see.
Oh, lovely. Thank you, Cobra. Thank you very, very, very much.
Okay. Thank you for the invitation.
Oh, lovely. Thanks a lot, Cobra. You're really enlightening. All good stuff. Loved it. Cheers, Cobra. All right, bye.
Hi, I'm Larry Warren. You're listening to the Unedited Audio Experience with Sandra Shufflebottom. Enjoy.
Didn't know what time it was, the lights were low, oh, oh. I leaned back on my radio, oh, oh. Some cat was laying down some rock and roll at a solo set. Then the loud sound, it seemed to fade, came back like a slow voice on a wave of fate. That weren't no DJ, that was Hazy Cosmic Time. There's a star man waiting in the sky. He'd like to come and meet us, but he thinks